What's happening, everybody? So today we're doing another video, and on this video we're going to be talking about a Web3 game that I am particularly excited for, which would be The Beacon. So The Beacon is a free-to-play action game. It's an RPG and it's currently in development on Arbitrum. We'll definitely go ahead and talk about some Arbitrum later on in the future. So I did want to do a video on this game the second it was, like, before it was even released, but I had all my clips and stuff pre-recorded and stuff on the first day, and just never got around to doing it. And then the game progressed and, like, the team was just advancing so quickly that I was like, man, I'm just gonna wait and I'm gonna go ahead and do it later, but I'll talk about it on Twitter. So that's what I did. I went ahead and I did a lot of updates and posting about it on Twitter, hoping that my Twitter followers would see it. And if anybody from YouTube is not following me on Twitter, definitely go ahead and do so, because I can post things a lot faster on Twitter than I can on YouTube here. But I'm definitely going to be working towards making that change and actually uploading here a lot often too. So if you're not following me, definitely go ahead and follow me at Raji De Niro, and I'll probably go ahead and follow you back. So with that being said, with The Beacon, guys, you can actually enter dungeons, defeat evil, and expand the beacon's light. So we're definitely going to go ahead and talk some more about that, but let's go ahead and talk just a couple seconds about Arbitrum, because I'm definitely looking towards doing a separate Arbitrum video, but I do want to talk about it. So what Arbitrum is a layer 2 scaling solution for Ethereum, so you can experience Web3 development the way that it was actually meant to be. With Arbitrum's suite of scaling solutions, you can benefit from things like faster speeds and significantly lower costs with the same level of security on Ethereum. So it's definitely going to be interesting to see how Arbitrum pans out, because there is supposedly a airdrop coming, and a lot of people are expecting that, and there's going to be a lot of talk about it when it does happen, if it does happen. So I don't want to put too much into the air just yet, because anything can happen, you know what I mean? So anyways, guys, that's Arbitrum for you guys. There's tons of transactions and just a lot of things going on Arbitrum already, and it's there's not even a token here yet, you know what I mean? So definitely something to look into. But anyways, guys, this is The Beacon. Let's go ahead and talk about this game, guys, because this game is just awesome. It gives me that old school nostalgic vibe back whenever it was like the 90s, and I was playing games back then. I mean, I play games now, but none of the games give me this kind of vibe, or at least haven't in Web3 at the moment. So this is The Beacon, guys. So you can play the prototype right now, obviously. And like I said before, I have clips, so I'll probably be running some old clips of whenever I first started the game. So they had the settlement launch. So pretty much what the settlement launch was the entry launch. I think I just heard a voice, and that was just kind of creepy. But the settlement launch was between November 25th and December 14th. The Beacon launched a playable prototype, and you're actually able to get into the game early, collect limited edition NFTs, and you can get on the allow list, which was the white list for the upcoming mint for eggs, which just recently happened on the 21st, I think. So that was just a few days ago, because now we're on the 27th. So you could try the game out for free back then, and you can still try to game out for free now. You just can't run into any dungeons at the moment because the dungeon is closed, but we'll get into that later. So here's just a little view of the pub area here. As you guys can see, it's really, really awesome. We'll probably be running through this here in a little bit, but they also have different milestones and stuff like that. And they have a roadmap as well, which we'll probably go over if we can find the roadmap here in a second. But anyways, guys, as you guys can see here, there is the Generation 0 Pet Egg Mint, which had a supply of 4,096. And only the allow list, which were the white list, it can actually mint the eggs. So that was the catch there. And then in mid-January, which is now, those eggs have hatched, which was just a few days ago, like I really spoke about before. And this is the cool part as well, is everybody that actually got in the beginning, which would be the founding characters, so they would have you mint characters, and those characters would be the founding characters of the game. And these are characters that are founding characters, and that would be the alpha release that's happening later on. And I think that's supposed to be happening the 31st, actually. So there is going to be allowing the founding characters to actually be sold on the market, because these games are actually NFTs. Like, these game characters are NFTs, the pets are NFTs, items in the game are NFTs. So it's definitely really, really awesome to see how they've integrated the NFTs with this Web3 game as well, because it's definitely caught a lot of attention over just the past few months that the game's been around. And here's the team. If you guys want to follow these guys, definitely go ahead and follow them on Twitter, because they definitely post a lot and engage with the community. I've sat in quite a few lives with these guys, and they're all awesome and contribute a huge amount to the Arbitrum community and just the crypto community in general. So definitely go ahead and check these guys out. But without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the beacon here. So this is the page for the beacon. Once you hit the play button, you obviously start playing the game. But right here, it kind of gives me Animal Crossing vibes just a little bit without the animal part. So as you guys can see, you can customize your room, and you can build your room and put your room together and stuff like that. And other people can actually vote and like on your room and stuff like that. Like, I like this room right here. I'll give it a like and whatnot. They're still working on quite a few things. So I'm not too sure what the likes will end up leading up to in the future. Maybe just cool events and stuff like that. But it's definitely cool to just come through and see other people's rooms. As you can see here, there's already 998 rooms available to look at. So there's a lot of players, obviously. Whenever I was playing, there's only maybe a few hundred, if that. And it's definitely improved within just a few months, because that was back in November, December, and now we're just 3 months later and there's already that many people playing. But anyways, let's go ahead and hit the play button shortly after we check out characters. So I've got two founding characters here. I've got one which would be Young Frost, and the other one which would be Dusk Watcher. You can't change the name of the character, so I did want to bring that up. And as you see here, you could actually do one dungeon per day, and you can do one tavern questionnaire per day. And whenever you do the tavern questionnaire, at the end of the questionnaire, you actually get a prize, which could be a potentially rare NFT, which is really awesome. And with the dungeon, you can only run the dungeon once a day, so there's not going to be any issue with like people over farming and just playing the game way too much, other than people that have a lot of characters, and that's because they put the time and money into the game to get those extra characters. So it kind of levels the playing field a bit there, because you could play as many characters as you want, but it doesn't mean you're going to get a rare drop every single time. So let's go ahead and play the beacon. So just waiting on this to load up, and once this loads up, we'll go ahead and we'll jump in here, and I'll show you guys just a few things. I'll just walk around a little bit, show you guys some of the older clips from whenever I first started playing the game and whatnot. Alrighty, so this is the beacon. So here's my room right here for my character, and your characters do share a room, so that's also awesome as well. So if you've got items on one area, then those items would pretty much relay over to the next. And it's very, very nice. I just like the style of the game is just awesome. So we can check the mailbox. There's nothing in the mailbox, but it's talking about eggshells because there was just that. So let's go into the tavern just. And kind of get like a storyline, like, so it kind of forces you to learn the storyline, which a lot of games don't do. And this is the entrance to the dungeon. As you see here on the right side, we got the runs for the dungeon. If you try to go in here, this guy will definitely block you off from going into the dungeon. whenever you're not allowed to go in there. So like currently no players can actually go into that dungeon to play the dungeon. As you see here, you can't get around this guy at all. So yeah, there is that. But for right now, this is the game, guys. And it's a really, really cool game to play. Let's go ahead and take a look at my inventory real quick. Or my character customization zone. So as you guys see here, we have just different colored items. And the different colored items basically specify the rarity of that item. As you guys can see, let's see if I can hover over any of these over here. Or I'd have to go to inventory, I think. Yeah. Well, let me go in the house really quick, see if that will work out a little bit better so we can show you guys a little something. Oh, crap. I didn't want to switch that. There it is. I'm not sure. You know, I definitely tell I haven't played in a little bit. Alrighty, but anyways, we'll go over the rarity here in a minute. But yeah, you could edit your room around. You could change stuff like the walls. You could change things in the room. And I don't really have too much stuff here, but it's something. It's a little something, you know. It's a little something. I got three beds just in case, you know. You never know what might happen. But anyways, let's go ahead and go over to the Trove market and see if we can get a better view there. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to log out here. And we are going to check out the market here with Trove. So first things first, let me go ahead and start back from the beginning. So this would be the trove.treasure.lol.lol. That's how I pronounce it. But anyways, this would be the pretty much like the open sea of Arbitrum, guys. So if you guys ever wanted to come here and buy and sell NFTs, you can come here. You can buy and sell different NFTs. And they got awesome games on here like Butterfly V2. They've got the Tales of, I don't want to butcher the name, Elnuria or something like that. I tried to get it on that one super early, but it was a bit too late. And then I didn't want to spend the extra cash to get into it because I was doing other things. So there is that. As you guys can see, we have the leaderboard and we have the beacon for the pets actually up here on the leaderboard at the moment. And these are the pets right here. So I just want to show you guys the pets really quick. And pretty much you can see just 4 hours ago, we had a pet sell for $601. So there's definitely a demand out there for the pets, and there's different buyers and different sellers. So it's not all just the same person, except for maybe right here as the buyer. So this person is loading up on pets right now, definitely spending a hefty amount on pets. But yeah, that's the pets. Let's go ahead and see if we can check out the items here. All right, so then we have this for the beacon item. So now I can kind of show you guys the like the rarity and things like that. So pretty much with the rarity, you have your epic items, which are going to be purple. You have your rare items, which are going to be blue. You have your legendary items, which are going to be, I think, yellow. Yeah, or gold, whatever you want to call that. And then you have your mythical items, which are going to be this color scheme. And then you also have the common items, which are just going to be like just a common color pretty much. Anyways, that's what you've got here, and you can buy and sell and just either continue to flip things, or you could just buy and sell them to edit your character and customize your room and things like that. And it's just really, really cool just to be able to go in there and just kind of play around whenever you ain't got have anything else to do for the day, you know what I mean? So it's definitely awesome to go ahead and do that as well. And I want to run over here really quick and show you guys the founding character before I go any further with talking about like the magic token and things like that. So these are the founding characters that I was just talking about earlier. So with the founding characters, you can actually sell them coming on the around the 31st, I think. Let's go ahead and check on Twitter really quick. So checking on Twitter here, I'm thirsting for a beacon founding characters. So there's a definitely people that are trying to get some get a hold of some founding characters here. Let's see the so I don't think that's the actual like pricing, but who knows. Things could jump pretty fast, pretty quick. But founding character transfers will become available on the 31st. So yes, I was correct. It will become available on the 31st, so you'd actually be able to transfer founding characters. So let's go ahead and come back over here and just take a look at a few of the founding characters out here. So these would be the founding characters, which are pretty much the characters you would use to play the game. And as you can see, we'd probably be scrolling here for quite a minute if we tried to scroll down to the bottom of this screen. So we're definitely not going to be doing that. But they all have different rarities about themselves. So let's go ahead and just click this guy. So there's just different rarities. You can see that character number 89. It's founding character 99.97 have this trait. And then they have the different other traits, like the head has a bear helmet. The eyes are wobbly eyes. The mustache. And it gives you the percentage for that trait, so you can see exactly how rare your founding character is. And they're all 100% locked at this moment until the 31st, which is 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. Yes, I use my finger still. So that's about 4 days from now. So there is going to be a little bit more of a wait before the price actually comes out for these guys. But it's definitely going to be interesting to see how the founding characters pricing moves, the market for the founding characters go, as opposed to the market for the pets, because the market for the pets took off a pretty fast, a bit more than expected. But the founding characters, I think there's a bit more founding characters than there are pets at the moment. So it's definitely going to be interesting to see how that works. And before we close out here, guys, I just want to talk to you guys about the magic token, which is a token that you can use, obviously, as you guys see here, to buy and sell NFTs and just stuff for this ecosystem on a Trove with Arbitrum. So pretty much you can use magic tokens. Magic is currently trading at $1.29. So if you want to get magic, it's $1.29. But back in, I think, November, a little bit before Thanksgiving, I was talking about it, and it was about like 23, ranging between 23 and 26 cents, as you guys can see here. And I was posting about it on Twitter. So if you guys aren't following me on Twitter, what are you doing? So I could definitely share things a lot faster there. So I was saying I was extremely wizardish on Magic back in December of 22. It was last year. And that was like 54 cents. And that's when it was moving off of that 27 cent range that I was just talking about. And definitely made a nice return on that. And I'm still continuing to make a nice return on that, because I'm actually sticking around the ecosystem. I don't plan on leaving anytime soon. And as you guys can see here, we've had a recent all-time high of $6. And I believe that Magic can easily move much higher than that, in my own personal opinion. So none of this is financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. Y'all already know the spiel. But that's pretty much what I'm looking at with the Magic token at the moment. And it's just interesting to see that just the different things that the community have been introducing regarding the Magic token. But we'll probably have to do a video on Magic separate, more than likely, just so the video doesn't go on too long that I'm doing right here, right now. But yes, you could pretty much use Magic tokens. You can also buy things with Ethereum as well. But it's mainly Magic token on the Trove website. So if you guys are interested in that, definitely go ahead and check out Trove on Twitter, and check out Magic as well, and just get into the ecosystem and just dive in and just have fun, you know what I mean. Right now you can actually claim a treasure tag. So pretty much what the treasure tag is like a gaming tag, pretty much. We'll see what we can do here. We'll go check out my page and we'll hit my likes. Pretty sure, yeah. So pretty much right here, you can actually own a founding character, blah blah blah. And then they were talking about the customization of like the treasure tag, which is pretty much your gamer tag. I feel like there was another post I liked. Yeah, I think it's this one right here. So they were pretty much introducing the treasure tag, and this is the treasure DAO right here. So if you guys want to follow them, definitely follow them. Tons of alpha over there in early releases on information. And pretty much your tag is a new gamer tag that will serve as your global player profile. So if my voice is getting a little bit scratchy here, guys, my cat's in the room. My nose is getting a little bit better, but still working on that. And I don't have a drink like I did yesterday. But pretty much you can reserve a tag right here. So what is a treasure tag? It's a global player profile across the treasure ecosystem. So pretty much your non-transferable treasure tag will serve as the basis for your global game profile and player reputation. So if you've got a, if you want to build like a reputation, kind of like having a high score in an arcade, it's just like that, guys. So if you want people to like recognize your name when they see you step into the game and they're like, oh snap, that's a gamer, or oh snap, that's a booty scratcher 96 or something like that, then yeah, that's pretty much what they'll like identify you as. And you'll be like, yo, he's pretty good, so we got to watch out for him if you're playing like a game like a Call of Duty or anything like that. But anyways, guys, that's pretty much the treasure tag there. You could definitely come here and check it out. It's a really easy process. I went ahead and did it last night. It only took like 2 seconds, literally 2 seconds. And you can go ahead and do that. But anyways, guys, that's all I've got for today's video. If you like my content, definitely go ahead and follow me at Raji De Niro on Twitter and subscribe to me here on YouTube and leave a like. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below, because I can definitely answer those. But guys, definitely go ahead and follow me on Twitter, because I can get to your responses a lot sooner. I did notice that there was a few of you that left comments here on YouTube and I didn't see them until about 2 days later. But I'm definitely, like I said before, I'm trying to change that. So I'll definitely have a presence on YouTube a bit more now that I've got the new setup and a bit more time to come on here and just mess around. But anyways, definitely go ahead and check out my Twitter page. I share trades and things like that. Share like things like the Beacon and just Web3 gaming in general, because I really, really like the gaming aspect of things. Just like super duper bullish on Web3 gaming and just crypto gaming in general. And that's just that, guys. If you guys like my content, definitely come here and subscribe, leave a comment one last time, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching if you made it this far.